And then she sends me a bunch of booty pics. Oh, lovely. So what she wants is validation. She wants me to say, oh my God, your ass is so nice. Oh my God, I love that ass. I can't wait to see it. She's not actually serious about meeting. She just wants a bunch of validation. What's up, guys? Welcome to our first ever texting rejection compilation. So in the past, I've shown you videos of me doing the impossible with good text game to get the date. In this one, we're gonna take a look at the other side of the coin. I'm gonna show you examples where despite my best efforts, I still got rejected. All right, so we're gonna go through three interactions where despite my best effort, I still got ghosted or flaked on. So let's take a look at the first one. So this is a chick who, you know, I've already gone through all the process. We met on Hinge, we were texting or flirting, she invested. Now I'm going to set up the date. I already soft closed, now I'm going for the hard close. I say, how's Wednesday night? Say 9, it works, where? Do you know where Red Bar is? Brickle, C, okay. And then also I want to make sure that she was cute. She had very few photos in which she looked good, but I want to make sure. So I said, by the way, do you have IG? I do, but I don't post anything. What's your URL? I'll add you. It's okay, mine is like half dog pics. I give her mine, added. And then, haha, you weren't kidding. So she literally had one pic on there. I say, I'm impressed that you were able to get 700 followers without one post, lol, which did seem a little odd. She says, I used to post, haha, I deleted long ago. Anyway, so day of the day, I say, hey girl, happy Tuesday, hi. Oh, so this is day before the date. Pick out a cute outfit for tomorrow yet? Not yet trying to decide. Oh, I'm sure it'll be lovely. So this is my little confirmation. So in this one, you know, I'm following all the best practices. Day before the date, you give a reminder. Day of the date, you confirm. Yo, sexy. Hey, I have to cancel tonight. I say, breaking my heart. Her name says, sorry, I have a headache. I've been sleeping all day and just woke up, but my head is killing me. It's the first time she's flaked. Plus, she said she had a headache. So I said, it's cool, feel better. I waited a few days and then I re-engaged. Hey, how are you feeling? Hey, I'm feeling a lot better. How are you? I say, that's good. We should celebrate. Give it a few days and she doesn't respond. I say, if you're too nervous, I understand. She says, I'm just so busy. Like, I'm not even going anywhere, just working. So when a girl says that, you might be thinking, oh shit, she might really be busy. Yes, everyone is fucking busy. It's a question of priorities. So if you're someone that she prioritizes, then she won't be busy. If you're someone that she's not gonna prioritize, then she will be busy, right? And for some reason, she's not prioritizing me. I say, I understand, I get super busy too. I'm sure we can both find a few hours if we want to though. This is a text I like to use when a girl says that she's busy, she doesn't respond. I give it a week and I say, or not. She says, hey Alex, just making sure, is this Alex from Dog Park? I think I should have been funny if I said yes and just trolled her. I say, it's Alex, but not from the Dog Park, lol. And she did not respond. I say, don't think too hard now. And she does not respond. So I wait another week and I send her the skeleton meme. It's just like a skeleton waiting for your text back like dead. She says, so busy, I'll get back to you soon. I say, too busy for a love question mark. Yes, don't have time to date or anything. Sorry. And I say, lamest level, 11 out of 10. So at this point, I have given up. I've tried several times. She's just being difficult. And she's just, even if I do get her to set up plans, she's probably going to flake. So at this point, it's time to let go. Now, some people would argue, dude, I would have given up a long time ago. True, I do like to be persistent and see where it goes. I've had, you know, as I've shown this channel, other situations where my persistence paid off, but this was not one of them. Okay, let's take a look at another one. So this was a chick who I was flirting with for a while, very much my type, and she was out of town. So I knew she was back, so I hit her up with, after she got back, make it back to Miami yet? I'm in Miami, we will have to celebrate. Haha, for sure, let me know. So I send her an audio message, I think inviting her out. She says, yeah, I guess we'll be better Saturday night. Right, let's do it, yeah. And then Saturday for my confirmation, hey girl, happy Saturday. Aha, I'm at the beach. Cool, what time are you free tonight? After 8? Yeah, let's do 9:30. What are you thinking about? Splitting a bottle of wine on my romantic balcony. She says, haha, sounds perfect. I say, good, question mark, good smiley face. And then like half an hour before the day, I say, I'm running a bit late, 9:45, okay. 15 minutes after we agreed on, she says, nope, I can't at that hour. Are you going alone? I text you better. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, you can't 15 minutes later, while I'm with friends drinking right now. So she was gonna flake anyway. You're not flaking on me, I hope. No, no, but I'm with them, my girlfriends, they came from Peru. Do you want to come to the wharf? And this is like typical hot young girl logic. Oh, my girlfriend's called me. Well, I haven't seen them in a while, so I'm gonna go hang out with them. And the guy, he should just know, he should figure it out, right? So I'm like, just tell him you have to go meet a handsome Russian guy. If they're real friends, they'll understand. And no response. I re-engage a few days later. Yo, sexy, hi. Are you still interested in meeting up? I'm going to the wharf, Miami now. Like, what the fuck am I supposed to do? Yes or no? I say, and and she doesn't respond. Again, typical hot girl logic. I think what she wanted to do was me to say, oh, cool, I'll just come and meet you at the wharf. Yeah, let me just give up all my plans and randomly come meet you out and, you know, follow you and your friends around, which actually, like, probably 25% of the guys she's talking to would agree to. I re-engage a few days later. I genuinely didn't take you for the flaky type. I'm not. I was working a lot, except for the part where she was at the wharf two nights in a row. And two friends from Peru came to visit. I was with them. That's why I told you I was at the wharf, but I thought you didn't want to know about me. This is also very typical, like, hot girl excuses, is they blame it on you. So, like, when they're not interested, they're like, oh, but I thought you weren't interested. Like, what? I'm trying to set up plans here. I understand. Yes, of course, I'm interested. I was just looking forward to hanging out with you, not you and your friends. Yeah, I understand, but now I'm with my friends. They're staying in my apartment. Okay, I'm like, how long are they staying for? Until Tuesday. I say, all right, we can just hang out Tuesday night then. And no response. So here I figured she was gonna flake, so I tried a little bit of a reverse strategy. So I tried preemptively flaking on her because I knew she was gonna flake. Hey, something came up, so I can't do tonight. Sorry, hope you're not mad. Actually, it wasn't just like just game. I actually was legitimately busy. Don't worry, it's okay. I'll make it up to you next time. And no response, of course, because she doesn't really give a shit. I hit her up about next day, unless you're married with kids already. What? I figured that might be the reason keep disappearing. I'm working, that's the reason. Here I'm just having fun. I say, at the strip club question mark is not a bad idea, or OnlyFans, all the cool kids are doing it, and no response. So I hit her with a skeleton meme, and she doesn't respond. I wait a week and I hit her with, if you're too nervous, I understand, haha, sorry, I'm working like crazy, honestly, I'm the worst, so sorry. I say, I get I'm busy too, but I'm sure we can both find a few hours if we want to, and no response. So at this point, there's a pattern of her disappearing. It's just a simple case of her just not prioritizing the meet. She either got laid or she just stopped giving a shit, or she had a bad experience, but for whatever reason, she's not prioritizing meeting me. And you know, I've tried quite extensively. At this point, I'm gonna call my losses and walk away. Here is the next example, saving the best for last. So this is a chick who was also very much my type, and she had a habit of sending me a lot of pictures showing off her very nice booty. So I'm actually, like, when girls do that excessively, I find it almost annoying. Like, I don't really want to see a bunch of nudes of you. I'd rather meet you in real life and see that shit with my own eyes rather than just keep sexting photos back and forth. So I say, yo, sexy. So here we're trying to, I'm trying to make shit happen. I'm like, yo, sexy. Then she doesn't respond. I say, don't be shy. Who said I was shy? And then I send her a goofy picture of my dog, Rhaegar. She doesn't respond. I wait like a week. Are you always this talkative? LMAO, I didn't think you were into me. So there we go. That's a line you commonly get for girls who are disappearing on you. They try to flip it on you. It's a pretty lame frame control attempt. I say, what made you think that? How sporadically we speak. Right, because you don't respond. So I send her a voice memo saying, but I always give girls the benefit of the doubt because sometimes, you know, maybe she just doesn't know. Maybe it's a legitimate mistake. So even though I'm pretty sure it's a frame control attempt, I'm still going to give her the benefit of the doubt. So I send her a voice memo. I'm like, hey, you know, I actually am interested in meeting you. But, you know, sometimes you don't respond. But anyway, we can get to know each other in real life. And she just responds with, you're a confident guy. I say, is that so wrong? And she disappears. I say, you know, for this to work, you have to respond, right? Sorry, you just haven't seemed that interested, so I don't know. You're hot, though. Typical young hot girl logic. I didn't respond to this guy, so it must be because he's not interested. So I think here I sent her a voice memo. It's not showing up. Again, I was saying, like, no, like, I appreciate that. You're cute, too. I am interested. But, you know, we have to respond for this to work. So, sorry, you just haven't seemed that interested. So, I don't know, you're hot. Oh, okay. Or she double texted. I say, honey, I'm interested, but you have to put in a little effort as well. Wow, I thought you blocked me. I'm sorry. Like, what? I say, well, why did you think that? Because my earlier text didn't go through. Okay, so she's having a little issue. I say, yeah, well, anyways, we should get together sometime soon. Wow, before nudes, you're proposing this? So yeah, this is like typical Generation Z logic is like, let's not meet, but let's just exchange a bunch of nudes and that's our sexual connection. I think this chick was like 19 or 20. I say, yeah, I prefer to see that in real life. She says, damn, a first. How do you know if we're sexually compatible? I don't, but there's only one way to find out. Fair enough. What's your schedule like? She doesn't respond. Don't worry, it's not a trick question. I like the persistence, but yet she doesn't. And then I believe she sends me another booty pic. I just respond with, are you always this difficult to make plans with? Are you always this conversational? You take 12 hours to respond and barely seem into me. How are we supposed to make plans? So what she's saying is, she's like, hey, I want you to give me nonstop validation and I'm just gonna respond to you when I feel like it, but I want you to give me a lot of attention and validation and maybe if I feel like it at some point, I'll engage. That's basically what she's suggesting. So I send her a voice memo and I say, I believe, I'm trying to remember. Oh, I said something like, Well, yeah, because you don't respond either. But anyway, like, why don't we actually make plans to get to know each other in real life instead of texting back and forth? And she says, it all sounds good. So I say, good. So what's your schedule like? And she disappears again. So you know a girl is not actually serious about meeting up. Whenever you ask buying questions like, what's your schedule like? They drop off. So I respond with, is there a reason you're playing these silly games? You sounded kind of mad in your last voice note. I don't want to piss you off. Yet she says, it all sounds good. Not mad, simply trying to make plans. And then she disappears. Look, if you're onto this, just let me know and I can stop trying. And she disappears, send her the skeleton meme. She says, I must give you credit for tenacity. So you can see, I'm very persistent. I must give you credit for making this as difficult as possible. I'm honestly not trying to. I just don't really like it. Guys who play too cool, and you're very cool. I like guys who are very interested. Like me quadruple texting her and re-engaging constantly, I guess, is not interested enough for her. And then she sends me a bunch of booty pics. Oh, lovely. So what she wants is validation. She wants me to say, oh my God, your ass is so nice. Oh my God, I love that ass. I can't wait to see it. She's not actually serious about meeting. She just wants a bunch of validation. Happy Valentine's, though. Here's me earlier. I say, I've been trying to make plans with you for a month now, dear. If you want even more just for me, you're going to have to earn it. A good start would be showing a bit of an effort to actually meet up. And she doesn't respond to that. So that was a very genuine, like, appeal. And if she doesn't respond to that, it means she's absolutely 100% not serious. And I say, or is that too much to ask for? And she doesn't respond. And then I give myself a question mark. She doesn't respond to that. At that point, I'm calling my losses. I probably would have given up much earlier if she didn't have a really nice booty. But you can see, this is the fucking shit I deal with. Now, the point here is that while you guys have seen a lot of examples on this channel of me being very persistent and working out, there's also a lot of situations where I'm very persistent and I play all my cards right and run a good text game and it doesn't work out. It's just simply part of the game. All right, hopefully you guys found this entertaining. Show us some love by smashing the like button, hitting subscribe, and clicking the bell for notification. And let me know in the comments if you want to see more rejections. Thank you guys for watching, and until next time.